Previously, we discussed how to convert scientific notation to standard form. Well, going from standard form to scientific notation is just as easy. Let's say we have a large number, say 234 million, with only the first three digits being significant. We want this to look like a decimal multiplied by some exponent of 10. Just as before, it's just a matter of counting. Again, we start with where the decimal point is located. For whole numbers, it's right after the final digit, right here. Now the goal is to move this decimal point left all the way to 2 without changing the value of the number. To do this, we use a simple trick. Divide by and then immediately multiply with 10. Since they cancel each other out, the final value stays the same at 234 million. But if we perform only the division and not the multiplication, we keep the same value while only moving the decimal point one place to the left. We repeat this nifty trick until we reach the first digit, 2. Done. Now let's simplify this. We said only the first three digits were significant, so we drop all the zeros. Also, 10 multiplied 8 times is the same as 10 to the 8th power. And there you have it, your first conversion. But you obviously don't want to go through this process every time. Fortunately, there's a shortcut. Just start by visualizing where you want the decimal to end up. With scientific notation, that'll be right after the first digit. Then count the number of places you need to move the actual decimal point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And that's the number you want as your exponent. Rewrite and voila, you have your conversion. Small numbers written in decimals can be converted using the same principle, only in reverse. Let's say we have the number 0.00000567. Just as before, we need to move the decimal point without changing the value. Only this time, we want to move it right, since we want it to end up right after the first non-zero digit, 5. In order to accomplish this task, we employ the same trick as before, but instead of dividing and then multiplying, we multiply with 10 and then divide. Now if we perform only the multiplication and not the division, we effectively move the decimal point right, without changing the original value of the number. Let's repeat until we get the decimal point to the right of the first non-zero digit, in this case 5. And there we go. Since dividing with 10 7 times is just 10 to the negative 7th power, we can rewrite this as 5.67 times 10 to the negative 7th power, and our conversion is complete. The shortcut is also the same. Visualize where you want the decimal point to end up, then count the number of places you need to move it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's your exponent, but remember, it's a negative exponent this time. Rewrite and you're done. If you get confused whether the exponent should be positive or negative, just remember the original process. If you want to move a decimal point right, you need to multiply with a 10. But if you want to keep the value unchanged, you need to divide with a 10 immediately thereafter. So if you're left with a bunch of divisions after you're done moving your decimal point, then your exponent should be negative. On the other hand, if you move the decimal point left, you'll be left with a bunch of multiplications, which means your exponent should have a positive value. And that's how you convert standard form to scientific notation. Stick science.